everybody, welcome to a brand new tutorial. So today we are going to be recreating this acrylic painting, which is of a beautiful sunset. There will be a list of all the materials I use in the description box below, and you can also download the reference photo in the description box. So let's head straight into the video. So I've squeezed out just a little bit of each colour on my palette. So I'm going to start with a fairly wide brush. This is a flat angle brush. As I say, I'm going to pop everything in the description box if you want to check exactly what model that is. So let's get started in popping in the background. So I'm going to start at the top, give your brush a little bit of a rinse. So I'm going to take some yellow ochre. I'm going to add in just a tiny little bit of black. I'm just going to pop that in the background up at the top. So yellow ochre with a bit of black. You probably want to take that to about halfway. So about that point, you want to just keep on taking that down. Add a little bit of water to your mixture just to make it easier to spread. But you don't want it watery, this isn't a watercolour lesson. Okay, so once you've come just past halfway, we're going to take some vermilion and we're going to add it into that mixture. And then we're going to paste that down sort of halfway in between that. And just add a little bit of water again if it's easier to spread. So again, in this mixture, just to clarify, we've got vermilion, yellow ochre and a tiny bit of black. Just to dull those colours a little bit. Okay, and I'm just going to blend that line now. So I'm going to take my wide brush and I'm going to go up and down across that line. And then starting at the top, I'm going to blend it down side to side. So you can do this as many times as you think that it needs it. I think that's okay, but again, if you feel like it needs more, go for it. And so now I'm going to take some vermilion and I'm going to take this straight from the tube, so it's quite vibrant, and just blend that in at the bottom. And again, we're going to do the same blending trick, so we're going to go across and then down. Here I'm going to blend it up into this bit a little bit more, so I'm going to take it across that way and I'm going to blend it down. Okay, so next we're going to take some black and we're going to add this in right at the bottom. Okay, so when we're going to blend this in, we're going to give our brush a wash because this black is going to contaminate anything where we put it elsewhere. So we're just going to wash that brush out right now. And if you're wondering why I'm being so messy, what it is, I'm actually using canvas paper and I popped some masking tape along the bottom. So obviously when I peel that off, there's going to be a clean line, but it's just a little bit easier rather than keeping a straight line all the time. Okay, so once you've washed your brush out, just once again, take it crosswards along that line. Then wash your brush out again. And take it down. Okay, so we're going to be adding another layer to this, so don't worry too much. But give your brush a wash out and then we're going to wait for that to dry. Okay, great, so now what I'm going to do is basically exactly the same thing as we've just done. So starting with my yellow ochre, and a bit of black. And if you followed my other tutorials, you'll know probably why we're doing the same thing again. It's just to build up the layers, and obviously right now you can slightly see through onto the canvas texture, and we don't want that. We want it to be like really nice, thick quality, nice paint on there. So I'm going to take a bit of yellow ochre with a bit of black, and once again just pop that in the top, and you can see this time that the colour is a lot more vibrant. Also, each layer, although it looks opaque, is very slightly transparent because of any water that we've added to it. So it just really helps to build up those layers, and obviously because each layer is slightly transparent, it just really builds up the nice effect and obviously makes it look a lot more realistic. If you need to replenish any paint, just feel free whenever yours runs out. Okay, so now I'm at this point, I'm gonna take my yellow ochre and I'm gonna add a little bit of vermilion. I'm just gonna start to blend that in. And then I'm going to take vermilion straight from the tube. And I'm just going to blend that up into the yellow ochre. Now, right now I'm just blending side to side because it's much thicker, it blends a lot easier, so we don't necessarily need to do like the up and down movement right now. But if you've got like a very thick line rather than a transitioned effect, then feel free, you can use that effect whenever you like. So now when we've got that effect, I'm going to take some black and I'm going to add that in the bottom. And as I said before, give your brush a really good rinse out at this point and then just blend that line. Okay, lovely. So once again, we're going to wait for that to dry now. And I definitely need to rinse my water out, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. So with acrylics, when I'm looking at a reference photo, I like to usually go in the layers of what it really is. So next we're going to focus on the clouds in the top left corner. So next I'm going to be using this paintbrush. It's a Terry Harrison Golden Foliage brush, and it's flat, and it's fairly tough. And it's going to be great for popping in some of those clouds. Okay, so next we're going to go for sort of the lighter outline of the cloud. I'm going to dampen my brush a little bit. I'm going to get some yellow ochre and pop a little bit of white in there. I'm going to add just a little bit of yellow. And so I'm going to start adding in some of those outlines of the clouds right now. So I'm just going to take my brush and sort of like at a 90 degree angle, I'm just going to sort of scuffle it along the canvas. And as you scuffle it, you can see that these little tiny more suggestions, it's not necessarily blended, but it's not like a hard sort of line either. And obviously clouds aren't hard lines, clouds are actually very, very difficult to get right. So you can work with sort of like a rounded brush stroke, or you can sort of go from side to side with the clouds that are sort of more moving to the side. And this is just sort of a basis that we're going to sort of be working from. Okay, so next I'm going to add in that line cloud that sort of goes horizontally across here. This is more sort of mapping it in at this point. Okay, so now we've got a little bit further down, you'll see that the clouds are a little bit more yellowy. So I'm just going to add in a bit more yellow to that mixture. And I'm just going to carry on adding in some of those little clouds that we can see moving downwards. Okay, that's brilliant. And then you rinse your brush out. Okay, so now we've added the yellow bits in, we're going to take some vermilion straight from the tube and add just a little bit of water as well. And we're going to then do a similar thing. So you can see that in the clouds further down, the outline of them, or the silver line as you say, are like a reddy hue. So we're going to pop those in now. And we're going to be popping the black on top of this. Okay, we're just going to take this vermilion and sort of go around where the sun is going to go. So I'm going to pop my sun here. So you can add it quite thickly as well because we're painting it on top of black. And I'm just going to add that in, as you can see on the reference picture. Okay, and that will need blending out now, so I'm just going to grab a bit of black and just go around it. Then I'm going to rinse my brush out and just blend over that. Okay, and then give your brush a really good rinse out again. Okay, so now we're going to start again from the top and sort of build up those layers a bit more. So I'm going to take some yellow ochre, some black, and a bit of vermilion, and we're trying to achieve the colour of the clouds that sit up at the top here. So once you've got that kind of nice dull grey colour, we're going to use the same effect. So we're going to hold our brush at a 90 degree angle, and following the reference picture we're just going to scumble over where we think those clouds are. So again, just lightly sort of scumble it over those little clouds. Now I feel like it's a little bit too black, a little bit too dull, so I'm going to add a little bit more yellow ochre and a little bit more vermilion into my mixture, just to make it a little bit more warmer. Okay, lovely. And I'm just going to take that same colour, sort of bringing it down here and then along these clouds here. Okay, great. So now we're going to add a little bit more black to that mixture and a lot more vermilion. You want to make sort of like a dull red at this point. And we're just going to take that from the side. I mean, you can see that big cloud there. Using the scumbling method, just bring that across. We're just trying to add some context for the later stages, some background work that we're going to obviously probably go over at some point. And you want to bring that down, but you want to be a little bit more haphazard with it here and obviously let some of that red background show. And then we're going to do the same the other side. So just where we popped in these highlights here, we're just going to go over that. And just leaving a fine line of red above the cloud. And the further you get down sort of these wispy, straight clouds, instead of going round, I'm just going to add in a few side-to-side strokes. So the next bit that we need to focus on is this middle sort of area. So just give your brush a really good washout. Okay, next we're going to be taking some yellow straight from the tube, which is kind of exciting. I'm going to add it on my brush just on the end, like that. So we're really in control of where this paint's going to go. And what I'm going to do is just look at the reference photo and just see where those really bright yellow bits are, because this is what's going to really bring the paint into life. So just underneath this cloud, you can see just a fair bit of yellow. Now we don't want to take this too far, just a very, very minimal amount. And then you just want to sort of bring that down a little bit into the sun. So you may want to use a different brush for this, because obviously this is flat and we're trying to draw a circle, but I'm just going to go ahead and do it with the corner. Okay, and then rinse your brush out. And at this point, I would just advise standing back from your painting, just taking it in a little bit and seeing how you like it so far. So doing that to my painting and looking at it, I realised that I want a lot more vermilion down here just to really bring it out a lot more, and also around the sunshine. So I'm just going to put that brush away for the moment, and I'm going to take a smaller brush. This is a 1/4 Pro Art Proline Plus, and it's a flat edge again, just very small obviously, because it's not a very wide brush. And what I'm going to do now is just give it a little bit of water. I'm going to take my vermilion, and this sun is still wet from the yellow that we just put on, and so I'm going to use that to sort of blend those lines in a little bit more. So take a little bit of water as well, just to free it up a little bit. I'm just going to go around this yellow. And then rinse my brush out. And then I'm just going to blend those lines in with the yellow. And then to blend that red in again, I'm going to take my black, go around the red. Rinse your brush out. And then just blend that line as well. And just keep going with the paint until you're happy with where it is at. Okay, so I'm going to add a little bit more black along here, along the bottom, just to make that more intense. And then I'm going to rinse my brush out and take some vermilion. I'm going to add a little bit of black to the vermilion on the palette, just so it's a bit more dull, and then I'm going to take that down here to just blend it in a little bit more. I'm going to rinse my brush out and I'm going to take some vermilion again and then blend that in. So this problem with this black is that it's just so intense that it will just really grip onto anything that it touches. So that's why you just want to keep rinsing your brush out. Okay, so once I'm happy with that bottom area, just rinse your brush out again. So I think I'm going to leave this cloud out because I just like the look of it without it. So feel free to go and add that in if you want to. Now I'm going to take some black and add it with some vermilion like we just did a second ago. And we're going to add in these clouds even darker over the top. So I'm going to start over here, and just on top of what we've already done, I'm just going to make those sort of cloud shapes. Obviously, the higher up we go, the more sort of vermilion we want to use. You just want to add in some of those shapes that you can see there. Okay. And don't be too precious about it, because it's clouds, and we can sort of make it up a little bit. And then the further sort of at the sides we're going to get, I'm just going to add more black. Again, at the sides, I'm just going to add black straight from the tube, just on the edges, just to bring it in a little bit more. Okay, and then give your brush a really, really good rinse out. Okay, so now we're going to give the clouds up at the top a little bit more dimension. So we're going to take some yellow ochre and some vermilion. We're going to take that sort of around the edges of the clouds, just to give it a little bit more intensity with the colour. And I'm going to bring that along these clouds as well. I'm also going to start adding in just little hints of that colour around here. Not too much, but just a little bit, just to blend those yellow marks in a bit more. Okay, then give your brush a rinse. Okay, now we're going to add the darker cloud on top. So we're going to take some black. Oh, I need a bit more. Okay, I'm going to take some black, some yellow ochre, and some vermilion, and mix it all together. You want it to be quite warm, so I would say a fair bit of vermilion. So you want it sort of like a dull red with a tinge of yellow, just to confuse matters. So I'm quite happy with that. So we want to be careful with this, because we don't want it to be as dark as the bottom half, but we just want to add in hints along the top clouds. So we can be quite heavy at the sides. I'm just using like a circular motion right now. And obviously you don't want to do all of it, because you want to let hints show through. And just on a couple of areas, I'm going to take it into these clouds as well. Okay, then rinse your brush out. Okay, next what we're going to do is take some yellow and add some white with that. So you get a lovely, like a light lemony colour. And we're just going to add that with on a few highlights. So even as far as up here, some very small hints. Nothing too much. Okay, and I'm actually going to take that and add it just in the centre of the yellow sun that we've added before. Okay, then rinse that out. Next we're going to take vermilion straight from the tube. And this is just a case of adding more highlights. So what I'm going to do first is just go around some of the clouds that we've popped in here. So as you can see here, just around these clouds, just see faint little outlines. And then I'm going to take this quite strong along this horizon as well, just to bring that intensity up. Around that yellow sun, I'm just going to add in straight from the tube, that vermilion. And then rinse your brush out really, really well. Okay, so for the last and final stage, what we're gonna do, we're gonna take some white straight from the tube. I think I poured out a little bit too much actually. And we're just gonna add that in the middle of the yellow sunshine that we've done. And that's just going to make that sun really pop out, really, really bright. Also, I'm just going to add just a slight tea at the top of that sun, just to give that illusion of it hitting the cloud. Okay, and I think that's about done. Thank you so, so much guys for watching this tutorial. I'm going to be trying to make painting tutorial videos on a much more regular basis. People really, really seem to like them, and you guys leave me such gorgeous comments about, you know, these painting tutorials. So I just want to thank you so much for taking the time out of your day to write a really nice comment. It means so much to me. So if you're not already, make sure you follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. Links are in the description box below. I hope you have a wonderful week, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!
There's a thin line between minutes and hours, and words become